Ever since he was a young boy in Texas, Sean Pleasance had promise. A valedictorian in high school, he got into Harvard, but chose Yale, majoring in economics. Wall Street beckoned, then came his own business.
I own all of my decisions and choices, good and the bad.
Today, he is homeless, living on the streets of Los Angeles.
It means it can happen to anybody.
It can happen to anybody. No one is, it's not someone else's problem. It's a problem we all could face.
Amid squabbles with his co-founders, the income dried up. And then he lost his rock, his mother, and the problems got worse. He is one of 60,000 homeless in the county of Los Angeles.
You'll find musicians, you'll find, you know, there's the photographer over there. The problem is with the cost of housing.
They all live in a small tent city in L.A.'s Koreatown neighborhood, dwarfed by gentrification that has taken over the area. A quarter of the nation's homeless now live in California, from L.A.'s Skid Row to the streets of San Francisco. Drug needles litter the sidewalks, and crews are routinely dispatched to clean up human waste, mere blocks away from some of the biggest tech companies in the world.
What they are doing to our beautiful California is a disgrace to our country.
President Trump may be on the verge of a major crackdown. According to the Washington Post, he is considering a directive to have the tents swept up, with the homeless moved to an unused government building. Critics point out that such an action would not only be illegal, but counterproductive.
The idea that we're going to force people into a facility that's probably located in a very remote area is not a solution.
Mike Dickerson co-founded a homeless advocacy group. He says a better solution for Trump would be figuring out how to build more affordable housing and providing better services, whether it's mental health or connecting people to jobs.
Often it is not framed as an issue of compassion, of trying to get people housed, but more of an issue of we need to get these tents off the street.
How would it strike you if all this stuff was just kind of removed, you folks were taken to some other place?
Then I would leave that other place immediately.
Sean, 52 years old and married to another homeless man, doesn't want to be confined by the rules of a shelter.
You just stretch your body.
Exactly.
This is where you sleep.
He has both a laptop and a cell phone. He's been occupying this space in Koreatown for 6 years and has been homeless for a decade. He admits to being a regular meth user, but spending just a few hours with Sean, he still possesses that intellectual curiosity that took him to the Ivy League.
I would prefer to be somewhere where I can still go to the library when I want to and go there and do the things I need to do.
But then there's the reality of life on the streets.
Every time you sleep, that's when you lose. That's when people come and take your things. I'm a heavy sleeper. I lose a lot.
Well, I spoke to Sean Pleasant's family. They have repeatedly tried to help him over the years, but he has rebuffed those efforts. Just shows you what a complicated situation this can be for both the homeless and their families. Now, John, in terms of federal officials intervening, what state officials will tell you is that they welcome those efforts. They welcome resources, but simply cracking down and not adding more housing, they say, is not a tenable solution.